Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel Irfan CFPS. In today's session, we are going to calculate the water demand for indirect sprinklers. Let us have a look at the indirect sprinklers. As you can see on your screen, this is indirect sprinkler which has a protective shield, and these sprinklers are used or specifically designed to protect commodity stored in racks. In other words, we can say that these are used to protect racked storage areas in warehouses. So we have various types of racks, such as single row racks, double row racks, and multiple row racks up to 4.7 meter deep. We shall consider one example in order to calculate the water demand requirements for in-rack sprinklers. You have to watch the full video since this is a critical topic. If you skip this video, you will be lost. Please watch till the end to get the total water demand for this particular warehouse considering indirect sprinklers. So coming back to our example, here they have given the type of facility as warehouse, and the CMDA type of sprinklers are also installed here in this warehouse, and the rack system or rack sprinklers are also installed in this particular warehouse. So we are going to calculate the water demand based on the storage height and type of commodity classification. Now we are going to calculate the water demand requirement for indirect sprinklers. You can see on your screen there are two tables which I have extracted from NFPA 13, chapter number 25, 2019 edition. Here, table 25.12.2.1. From this table, we can identify or determine the number of indirect sprinklers to be considered in our design to calculate the water demand. And from this particular table, table 25.12.3.1, we can calculate the or determine the minimum design flow or pressure for indirect sprinklers. So I will explain you in detail. Now just I will take my pen tab, just a minute. Here, yeah, now we have taken. So the type of storage not meeting the definition of miscellaneous. So we are going to consider this particular table. And if you want to know about the definition of miscellaneous storage, you can check NFPA 13 definitions. So in our case, the commodity class is class 4, and rack type is open type racks. Ceiling sprinkler we have already installed as per the project requirement CMDA sprinklers. Number of required in-rack sprinkler levels are more than one we need to install, and number of rack sprinklers in the design, this is very very important, this will be 10. So we need to consider 10 sprinklers to calculate the in-rack sprinkler demand. So now from this table we got how many sprinklers to be considered. And now from table 25.12.3.1, we can calculate the minimum design flow from one particular in-rack sprinkler. That will be, here you can see this will be the case. And here class 1 through class 4, class 1 through class 4 and group A plastic. You can consider this one or this one since we have CMDA sprinklers here as well, CMDA sprinklers here as well. And now here the storage height, they have given up to 25 feet. We need to consider this particular row. But now we have more than 25 feet storage height. So we are going to consider the flow as 30 GPM. So from one sprinkler, 30 GPM has to be considered. So total in-rack sprinkler demand will be 10 multiplied by 30, 300 GPM. But in order to calculate the pump requirement, we have to calculate the total water demand, which will be, you know, checking in our next slide. See, this is very important slide. Here, don't miss any particular portion because we are going to calculate the total water demand. This is different from our previous particular topics where we calculated the ESFR or CMSA or CMDA sprinkler demand. So just I want you to concentrate on this particular slide. So here we are going to calculate the total water demand for the entire warehouse. So I have my pen tab with me. So now so many are confused on how to calculate the total water demand if ceiling sprinklers are installed plus in-rack sprinklers also installed. So now so many are confused, and some say that, you know, we need to add this thing, like ceiling sprinkler shall be added to the indirect sprinkler demand to select the fire pump. And some say, no, only we need to consider the ceiling sprinkler demand to select the fire pump. And some say, you know, I have seen that they say that only indirect sprinkler demand to be added with hose stream allowance in order to finalize or select the fire pump. I will explain you in detail what exactly NFPA 13 states. Before we move ahead, just I will erase all these things so that I have a clear space to explain you in great detail. So just a minute. I hope you are able to understand the concept of this indirect sprinkler water demand calculation. This is the hot topic available in the market. So many are requesting me to, you know, prepare this particular video on indirect sprinkler. So here I will take one more color. Now coming back to our topic. Yeah, here I will write it. So NFPA 13 states, I will summarize for you, that ceiling sprinklers demand shall be added to indirect sprinkler demand, but please wait, but or only in case the pressure at the connection point is same. What does it mean? These are not the exact words of NFPA 13, but for you to understand, I'm, you know, using these kind of words. So what does it mean? I will just try to draw one you know, riser diagram. For example, we have the riser going to the ceiling sprinklers. Here we have one gate wall and check wall and so on. So from this particular riser, we have one more point, and there is one more riser which is going to the in-rack sprinklers. So now this will be the above ground piping. Okay, so above ground piping. So this will be the connection point. I will take one more color. So this will be the connection point. We make it as A. So A is the connection point between the ceiling sprinkler riser and in-rack sprinkler riser. So this is the connection point. So here at this particular A, we need to have same pressure, then only we can add the demand of this X and this Y. So I will explain you, since we have in our example, we already calculated the indirect sprinkler demand, which is of 300 GPM. You can refer to my earlier slide. And for example, we got, as per the hydraulic calculation, the pressure required at this indirect sprinkler riser is 75 psi, and since we have installed CMDA sprinklers, there is separate calculation to calculate the CMDA sprinkler water demand requirement. For example, we got 700 GPM requirement for the ceiling sprinkler at 85 psi. So here you can see that I will take one more color, maybe blue will be better. So here we have 75 psi for indirect sprinkler system demand, and for ceiling sprinkler system demand 85 psi. So both are not matching, so we cannot add 300 GPM to 700 GPM. So this will be wrong calculation. So what we need to do, we need to make sure that we get this 75 psi will be converted to 85 psi. How it will be done, I will explain you, since there is one particular formula. So please you have to listen carefully to understand this particular concept, otherwise you will be lost. So now we already know the formula, K is equal to Q by root P. Here we need to consider the Q as 300 GPM, which we got for the indirect sprinkler, and root P will be root 75 PSI. So here 300 by root 75, we will get about 34.6 K factor. So what we need to do, we need to consider once again Q is equal to K root P formula. Now in this particular case, here what we are going to do, we will consider this particular K factor 34.6, but root P will be root 85 PSI. So you have to go through thoroughly, and now we are going to get the Q value as 34.6 multiplied by root 85. So we will get around 319 GPM. So I will just erase the portion which is not required so that we can summarize and calculate the total water demand. So now here we have the in-rack sprinkler. So in-rack sprinkler demand 300 GPM at 75 PSI, and ceiling sprinkler demand about 700 GPM at 85 PSI. Now we converted this 75 PSI by using this formula. So the flow, revised flow to meet the pressure is, you can see here, 319 GPM. So it means, I will just erase once again, since we have limited space, I need to erase all these things. So one second. Okay, so see how critical concept is this. So we have now, I think this will be fine. I think so, yeah. This doesn't look odd. Okay, so now we calculated the revised sprinkler demand. So now we have the revised sprinkler demand as 319 GPM at 85 PSI and 700 GPM at 85 PSI. So here ceiling sprinkler, here we'll write rack sprinkler. So this connection point A, now we have 85 PSI. Now we can add these two, 319 plus 700. So we are going to get about 1019 GPM. So this will be the total water demand for this particular warehouse. So this is how you calculate the water demand requirement. With this, we finished our NFPA 13 training module. If you are happy with the content which I have shared with you, please do like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Irfan CFPS. Thank you very much for your support, and we are going to start NFPA 20 training module in our future classes.